please like and comment below and subscribe and share for more first-person encounters.
Case A011-1, the McDunn Mine Train Explosion. A friend referred me to your articles about strange occurrences in West Virginia. The Mothman encounters stirred memories of an incident that took place when I was a girl. The strange incident took place near Powelton, West Virginia in December 1934. I was 8 years old. At the time, my father worked for Elkhorn-Piney Coal in McDunn. He and the other miners would take a train to the mine each day. The day before Christmas Eve, my father mentioned an unusual sighting he and the others on the train had while traveling back to Powelton from the mine that evening. As they looked out towards the east, they noticed a very large bird flying above the trees. My father was a very simple man and did not believe in any nonsense, but this large bird really caught his attention. He described it as a freakish-sized owl, very dark in color. The sky was getting dark, but they could still make out the large form. He said it also looked at the train as it flew over the trees. Nobody on the train could figure out what it was. The mere fact that my father even mentioned it suggested that it must have been an unusual sight. My father was scheduled off from work for 3 days during the Christmas holiday. On December 27th, he was getting ready for work, but said he felt poorly. My mother was concerned because he had a high fever and awful chills. She insisted he stay home and telephoned the doctor. My father was reluctant on staying home and put up a good argument, but my mother was not going to back down. She put him to bed and waited for the doctor. Well, we waited for hours until the telephone rang. The operator told my mother that the doctor was at McDunn. There had been a horrible train explosion. She could not talk, but said that the doctor's wife asked her to contact us. My mother was pale when she told my father what had happened. I remember they both started praying and crying. For years, both of them thought the large bird was an angel sent by God as a warning, and that my father's life was saved for a reason. My father never went back to the mine. It turned out that he had contracted polio, though he was very lucky since he survived it with only a slight limp. We soon moved away to a small town in Kentucky, where my father found the calling and became a Pentecostal preacher. He told his story of survival to anyone who would listen until the day he died. I happened to read your stories while looking on the internet with my great-grandson. I always assumed my father saw something more divine. That is what he always believed. I am not so sure now. Thank you, Sir Emma.
Case A011-2. Are the Mothman prophecies real? My name is Megan. I am forwarding a summary of an experience that I and a friend had in August 2010. My friend and associate Kyra and I traveled from Columbus, Ohio to Ravenswood, West Virginia on business. While we were there, I wanted to make a side trip to Gallipolis, Ohio, in order to visit relatives I had not seen for quite a while. After our meeting and presentation, we drove onto Ohio Route 7 and traveled south along the Ohio River towards Gallipolis. We had a nice, though brief, visit with my relatives. Around 6 p.m., we left their home and drove a few miles north on Route 7 to check into a hotel near the local airport. Around 7:30 p.m., we decided to get dinner and found a quiet restaurant so we could eat and work. After we finished, Kyra needed to go to the store and pick up a few items that she forgot to pack. We headed to a Walmart that was nearby the restaurant. After we finished shopping, we were walking to the car when I noticed a woman running through the parking lot. When she reached her car, she looked back in the direction of the store, then hurriedly got into the car. I quickly looked in the same direction and saw what looked like a large bird flying above the roof of the store. It was difficult to see, but when it swooped downward, the parking lot lights would shine off of it. It looked like it was either oily or had shiny leather-like skin. Whatever it was, it had a wide wingspan. I would guess it reached 8 to 10 foot across. It circled above the store for about a minute, then just disappeared. We were both somewhat shocked at what we witnessed, but figured that it was just a huge bird. Since it was dark, I figured we had misjudged what it really was. We drove back to the hotel and decided to call it a night, so we could get an early start on the drive home in the morning. I got ready for bed, but thought I would watch some television first. By this time it was around 10 p.m. or so. I must have dozed off fairly quickly because the next thing I remember is frantic knocking on my door. I stumbled out of bed and checked who it was. It was Kyra and she was obviously upset. She rushed into my room and said, "It is here." I said, "What are you talking about?" A little bit perturbed that she woke me up. She said that she was laying on the bed reading when she heard something in the hallway. She got out of bed, walked to the door and listened to what she thought was scratching sounds. After a few minutes the sound stopped, so she went back to bed. Not long after she lay down she heard more scratching sounds but, from outside her window. Again she got up and peeked through the curtains. This time, something looked back at her. Our rooms were on the second floor in the back section of the hotel, and both looked out onto a small parking lot and a large field beyond that. She could see, what she described as, a bald ugly man with wings who was looking directly at her with large bulging eyes that lit up bright red. It was there for only a few seconds. It then spread its wings while running at the same time towards the end of the parking lot, and lifted off the ground like a bird. "You are kidding, right?" I muttered to her. "Meg, I swear to God that thing is out there, and it knows we saw it." I knew the only way I was going to get some sleep was to allow Kyra to stay in my room. The next morning we woke early, checked out and drove back to Columbus. Kyra did not mention the incident from the previous night during the ride. In fact, she has still never said anything else about it. We continue to be good friends and have a very good working relationship. But I got curious. I had never heard about the Mothman or any of the tales associated with it. I grew up in Texas and had only lived in Ohio for a few years. I moved into my mom's house after she had passed away. Her relatives lived throughout Ohio, but I had never been told any of the stories. This is the reason I am writing to you. We were near Point Pleasant, West Virginia when we had this encounter. Do you think that it is possible that this was a Mothman? I read some of your posts recently, and I am starting to believe that Kyra actually saw something supernatural. In light of the prophecies of danger that this thing is supposed to warn people about, Kyra has had some bad luck and tragedy since that day. Her husband suddenly left her, she had a fire in her house, and she severely injured her leg in a fall. Could this be connected? I personally do not believe in predictions, either good or bad. But I will admit that these have been strange times since we witnessed whatever it was.
Case A011-3. Possible Mothman. I was driving back to my home in Grove City, Ohio at about 9 p.m. on February 22, 2019, when I saw something very strange. I had just made a turn off Route 104 onto Boer Road and was driving around a sharp turn when I saw something brown on the side of the road. I first assumed it was a deer since I have seen several on this road before, but as I got closer, it was too big to be a deer. The best I can describe this object is that it looked like a big piece of brown shag carpet about 6 to 7 feet tall and about 10 feet wide. As I came close to passing this object on the side of the road, it folded up like the rug was being folded in half. I flinched and swerved out of the way because as it folded I thought it was lunging toward me and coming after me. I just sped up and kept driving home. I did not tell anyone what I had seen for a few days because I was so baffled and did not want to believe that I saw what I did. After replaying the sighting over and over in my head, I decided to tell my wife and we started looking on the internet, things that might match what I saw. The closest thing we could come up with is the Mothman, except I did not see any glowing eyes, but if the eyes were reflective, I would probably not have seen them because the creature was facing the road and not my headlights. Anyway, this was the strangest thing I have ever seen. Brian P.
Case A011-4. Ominous winged humanoid observed in Ontario, Canada. I do not want to sound crazy, but a few years back I believe I had a sighting, and just recently in 2016, I had a strange encounter which this one could have been my imagination. If nothing else, I am just quite curious and have been over the years since the initial sighting, which would have been around 2007 to 2008. I could pinpoint the day closer if I thought about it. I had just fallen asleep one night and awoke to see a dark figure with wings perched on top of the neighbor's roof watching me. Its eyes were red, I believe, they were like a cat's eyes with its night vision. It was not like an owl like some have mentioned, but it was a shiny black creature with large wings and almost shiny skin or coating. This creature looked to have very muscular arms and legs. This creature had a very nice face of a man which left me wondering afterward if it was a good thing or a bad thing. It scared me to the point I moved away from the window and did not want to look, staying awake all night. I called some friends the next day explaining what I saw, but believing it to be some sort of angel or dark creature, that did not mean well. Less than a year later, I was diagnosed with cancer. I went into remission and after many years thought I had beat the cancer. The second so-called sighting of something strange and black that seemed to affect the lighting on a street lamp blinking off and on erratically happened, but I did not see clearly enough to recognize if it was the same strange dark figure. Months later, I was diagnosed with cancer metastasis that is terminal. I am not saying the cancer diagnosis was related to these sightings, but just a strange coincidence. There have been other strange things with energies around over the years, but I do not want to assume anything. Unlike many other sightings, I do not live in Chicago. I live in Mississauga, Ontario, Canada. Just wanted to reach out and try to understand this. So hoping you can shed some light on any of these ordeals if possible. Kindest regards, BD.
Case A011-5. That winged man hit by delivery truck. I am 32 years old and had never seen anything supernatural or alien in my life until last summer. I had always been, and still am, very much a skeptic, and to this day, I try to convince myself that what I saw was actually a really big hulk or something. But, I know I am lying to myself. It was around 3:45 a.m. I am driving west on 322 towards Chesterland, Ohio. I am driving a Freightliner box truck with a load of newspapers. In the summertime at night, there is always a layer of fog hanging down around the ground, and the moon was bright, and the stars were out. Going about 50 miles per hour through the hills, I see this dark figure in the moonlight that was coming right at me. It looked huge, so I slammed the brakes and actually ducked down instinctively because I was driving right towards it at windshield level. I heard a big thud as the figure had gone over the cab and smacked right into the flat aluminum box right behind the cab, but probably 40 miles per hour. I kept my foot on the brake and came to a stop on the side of the road, probably about 75 yards from where the impact happened. Wondering if it had smashed in the top of the box and thinking maybe I could see what it was I hit, I got out, looked around. The box was not smashed in, so I walked around to the back of the truck, and that is when I saw it in the moonlight almost as clear as day. This thing was huge. I thought for sure it was dead, but all of a sudden it rolled over, and that is when I saw its bat-like wings, not bird-shaped. It rolled over and stood up on two legs and was at least 6 feet tall. The thing looked right at me with its red-orange eyes, and I was literally frozen in fear. I could not move at all. Then it spread its huge wings out, jumped up and flew off. I ran back to the truck and took off towards Chesterland as fast as I could and spent the rest of the night on edge and trying to rationalize what I just saw. The closest thing I could describe it to is the Jeepers Creepers monster, but I was not that close to it that I could see facial features and much detail. Just the 6 foot tall bat winged man with orange red eyes. I do that route for work every week, and every time I go through that stretch on 322 I get uneasy. It freaks me out. Andrew.
This is Lon Strickler. If you like this program, it would help us if you would give it a thumbs up. Then subscribe and click the bell icon so you get notification when we upload new first-person encounters. We have many more to come very soon. And by the way, if you have a suggestion or an experience of your own, please leave a comment.